Here we go. It's another Prosperity Mix tournament against Wolf Red. First two, 2.5 wins. I'm first player. Expand and Bishop are the only treasures. There's groundskeeper, so as always on these kingdoms you build, there is Sword the Earth, so you have to keep that in mind. There's also Secret Passage Chariot Race. So I want to ferry something. I could already open Passage Chariot Race. I mean, if they collide, put an estate on top. It's not great. It's actually probably pretty bad. I need to get expand, so I need to hit 5 after I ferry it. Might be passage silver. Kind of would like to do without silver, but yeah, I don't really know. Let's get the passage. So passage is good for your chariot races, but you can also try to defend putting a high cost card, 6 cards down. It's probably unlikely when we get thin, but because you don't have enough cards in your deck to draw stuff. So here, if I find the passage next turn, I can put an estate on the bottom, have 5 coppers in hand, so I could ferry the expand now. I think I'm doing that. It's pretty good. I get expand here. Looks like he picked the wrong card. There's somehow no way to undo that for some reason. So I guess he also gets to 5 next turn. The question is, what now? The only, I know we also have coin. I was gonna say the only village is Crown. So I wonder, should I just take another expand now and then re-ferry? That seems okay. Ferry on Grand Market. Yeah, seems fine. Buy another passage here or chariot race. Second passage is good if you if the expands collide, you can uncollide them. Yeah, chariot race can wait a bit. You can also put your estates, so you can trash them with expand. And he gets the. Okay, so I do have 2 expands, but he gets the current market now, I guess. Don't see anything better than that. Kind of like having 2 expands. Chariot race. This is probably just a crown. Do I put the estate the bottom or so that I see it next turn? Maybe I put it at location 2. Let's I think I want to see it next turn, so let's just top it. Meh. Yeah, I thought maybe I put it one down so that I have a higher chance of seeing my passage, but then if I don't see the passage and no estate, that would have been unfortunate. But I had another estate down there, so I think it was better to put it out of sight of this starting hand. Oh well. So that I could have saved the. Oh yeah. Bottom left the expand if I had seen my second passage. Anyway, here I just turn this estate into a grand mark and I buy a coin. But I do have copper on top, so it wouldn't have mattered. Our decks are pretty similar. Not sure I need the coin, but I think one can't hurt. Yeah, I really like that the second ex having the second expand, even though they just collided. Should kind of give me the advantage in the long run. Can turn my coppers into chariot races and so on. Other than that, we basically have the same deck. Basically, he has the chariot race and I have the coin. He trashed the silver, which I didn't really see, but it's fine. Second crown. This is also another crown. Let's put silver six down, so. So maybe here to have at least three costs on top if he plays his chariot race, but he doesn't. So there's a crown in here. Play the passage first. Huh, well. If there's a nah, let's just bottom deck the expand. Nice, turn this into current market. Just buy a current market. Okay, crown the expand, turn two coppers into two chariot races. Now I have a coin on the mat, which I don't know if I need to call at any time, but maybe. Well, having two expands actually isn't that big of a deal. You can always crown them. So probably all the grand markets first and some crowns, and then at some point you want to buy like double crowns keeper turn, and then somebody doesn't pay attention and the other player piles something like that. That was a good turn for him. Crown race, I'm expecting. No. Don't like that as much. He already has lots of secret passages. And only one chariot race, so he doesn't really profit from that all from them all that much. Okay, this should be also a good turn for me. Maybe I can. No, I can't. Well, maybe I can. Maybe I can crown my second expand, but I already have seen one crown, so it would have to be with this crown. Yeah, we're pretty much even here, I would say. He might be a bit, tiny bit ahead. So let's play one current market. Let's play another current market. Let's play passage. Bottom back to copper, and now I have to crown the current market, I guess. Well, it's not like that's a bad thing. So I have quite some money. I wonder if it's at some point you want to ferry the crowns, but it's probably too late. But well, you might still do it so that the current markets cost six again and make your chariot races better. So here I turn copper into chariot race. Just buy two current markets, I guess. Could also do silver into. Nah, let's get rid of the coppers. Wait, why didn't I? Yeah, I don't want to undo that. But I of course should have top decked the silver. Huh, maybe actually not, but yeah, I guess so. Don't want a second coin. Well, now the silver's in the shuffle, that's what I why I meant maybe not, but it probably would have been better to top deck that over copper. He already got 3 VP from the race. They don't really matter in the end, I guess, but all right, the piles, current market and races are almost gone. It's just, well, I could also top deck and expand. It's probably better. Let's see what he has to offer. A copper. But I'm still not calling here. It's not worth it. Here I could think about putting expand six down just to mess with his chariot races. He has a bunch of them by now. Did he shuffle? Yes, he shuffled. I would also like to play, of course. All of these expands, but might be a thing here. Let's actually do that. So top two, three, four, five. Those are the cards that I draw, right? And then here, I guess. So wait a second, that was the wrong thing. Got distracted by my phone. So two more races. Should be safe, even though it's actually not that clear. I think it's safe. I mean, safe is relative. He has the points lead and let's see if I messed up the expand. I hope not. Should be right on top now. Ka-ding. He might still win. this turn, which would be unfortunate, but maybe I should have just taken silver. That felt so bad, though. If he can't win, then he should score, but he might just have it. Yeah, looks like it, right? Six spies. 1, 2. Yeah, that should be a win. I think he has it in hand. He has the crown in hand, the expand in hand. He can expand into Grand Market and then buy the Grand Market ferry and the passages. Seven. Maybe it's not so easy. Maybe it's not so easy. He does have another crown somewhere. Did he reveal it? Also, why don't we see what he has in hand with the chariot race? It's so inconsistent. Because you see it when you play like Hunting Party. But now I don't want to go through the log and see what's in his hand. Well, I only know three cards anyway. Should have taken maybe only one chariot race and the silver. Could have also trashed, but that's so stupid, trashing my crown into a province. So no time for groundskeepers, apparently. Doesn't seem to be easy, at least. Maybe it's not there. But he can still score a bunch and then probably have a hard time. Okay, that wasn't probably the way to go for the win, I would say. Now he only has 6 gains, 7 gains. Well, that's still enough, but maybe he doesn't have the money now. So let's see if he... Let's say expands. Okay. Okay, so not going for it. Well, he just didn't have it. Is what I mean. So there's expand on top. Let's start just with crowning the Grand Market. I guess that's always happening. Okay, what's my last card? That would be cool to know, right? Did I play my secret passage? This shuffle. Yeah, I put the expand down. I have 5 grand markets. How many coppers? Ah, it's just so annoying to figure that out now.
Wait, is it just a crown? Might be just. No, I crowned my expand last turn to trash two coppers. Might just be a copper. Trashed five coppers already. So it's not a copper. Yeah, I think it's another secret passage. Wait, first of all, I can just check if I have some miracle win here, but it doesn't look like it. Let's play the Scrimmage Market. Was another chariot race. Okay, so I'm probably just playing these. I wonder if I should put, let's say I put a Grand Market in here, play these chariot races. F12, 13. Let's say I have something like 16. By Grand Market, Ferry Ch Passage, 7-9. It's not enough, so I think I just draw here. Ah, okay, did he? No, that was just luck, right? Yeah, that's unfortunate for me. I think I have to expand the crown into a province and then hope that I draw like copper so I can get more provinces. Well, just need to draw copper for double, but that didn't happen. Okay, let's still do that. Then turn this into silver and buy province crown. What do I need to buy province duchy? Could also do province double duchy. Wait a second. Do I have to win now? Silver into duchy, grand market, that's 8. Ferry the passage. No. Silver into Grand Market. No, it's also not working. No, I'm just a bit short here. Yeah, I think I go for the full points. Or is it a crown? Let's get the duchy. Maybe I missed a win, but I don't think so. Let's see what I have on top. Chariot race. He can probably score quite a bit here now with the chariot races. Would have liked to get double last turn. I mean triple, basically, but... Well. It was good as it was. Let's see what he can do. Kind of like the starting hand. I hope he can't win here. I have a big points lead, but I also have 5 grand markets to his 3. But he does have more crowns. Yeah. Okay, what happened? He trashed copper into silver. Province, silver, estate, okay. So maybe now I can do something, but now my deck is kind of garbage. I don't want to lead with the cherry dress. Let's just put the copper away. I mean, I could also top deck the passage. Whatever. I think I want to see what he has on top. Secret passage. Oh, that was a good timing. Okay, so let's score a bit with the thing. So I want to play to raise in case I find my crown. I can also expand this grand market into a province. It doesn't seem correct though. So I have 4 or 5 gains. It's still not enough. I can double province, which might also not be enough, but could also mill 2 and buy 1, but that seems just very bad. Oh, wait a second. I can mill 2 and salt. That's what I can do. Phew, I'm happy that I saw it just in time. I somehow missed salt somewhere in the middle. Maybe there was something earlier with salt. Anyway, it's nice to win that. Where's the thing? Kingdoms. Yeah, cool. Cool board. It was his start, wasn't it? No, it was my start. Oops. Yeah, it was. No. Something went wrong again. Just too stupid to do this. Just copied the thing, and I also cleared the selection. So copy, advanced options, kingdom cards, clear. Okay, now that looks better. And then I guess I must have clicked on Academy, the very top one, for some reason. So, what's going on here? Pathfinding is pretty good. The only trashing is bishop. So I open. The only buy is tragic hero, so it's a bit unfortunate because they will pop. So silver plaza. Maybe we do have enough villages, so doesn't matter if you end up with just some number of plazas. So silver is clear, and I think plaza is better than another silver. He just goes without silver, which I can also see. Settlers, yeah, actually settlers are pretty good, but let's get the plaza, because you want to mint at some point. I said mint is the only, bishop is the only trashing, but there's also mint. So now if I, next turn should be pretty great, right? I can probably trash 5 coppers with mint. And do I want to do that? That's the next question. I think I want to do that. Okay, silver misses, which is pretty good in this case. I have one silver, and the plaza. It's just too tempting to not do it. Hitting 5 will be a bit of an issue, but I can mint this one silver, I think. I wonder if I should get a bishop now. That might make some sense. So he's going hard for the settlers. Maybe he wants to pathfind them. Should I get one? It's pretty good with plaza, right? So I do think that I need to mint this silver. I could also get the bishop now. I only have 2 coppers, so the settlers are not all that great for me. Yeah, I'm already half regretting the mint. But only half. Because it's just so low tempo. Copper. Nope. So 3rd silver, yes, please, and then get Border Village Tragic Hero. yes, take the silver. He's probably ahead now, but it's actually hard to tell for me. He has this plaza settlers thing going on. And he, yeah, just has more. What? Okay, that was pretty good. Seven coppers. Wow. And then going for fool's gold also makes sense, but he only has one buy currently, but he can mint them. Yeah. Bandit also trashes fool's golds. Yeah. So I need to pathfind something. I wonder what that is. Do I want to take more silvers? I think I want to take more silvers. And this is just another border village tragic hero. Could take a settlers with it, but I don't want to do that. Could have also path found something. So he could trash two of his three estates from my bishop. And I'm sitting here with the silvers while he has the fool's gold, so it doesn't look great. Well, he's buy limited though. He needs more tragic heroes. Maybe pathfinding isn't all that great because it pops your heroes. Yeah. So, do I want to keep this tragic hero? I think I want to keep this tragic hero. Settlers not happening here. Coppers in the discard. Don't want to trash my mint now. Probably, I'm not sure. Don't want to put a copper on top. Yeah, whatever. Think I'm just. So I have five. 6, 14, 3 buys. If I'm pathfinding, then mint is pretty decent. Actually, let's maybe not do that. Because right now I have 14, I could pathfind the border village and get border village, bandit camp, or border village something. Except I can't count. So let's trash that. Should I get a bandit? Maybe. Yeah, Need more border villages now. Yeah, fool's golds are just much more efficient than any other thing. Yeah. I like having the bishop, but other than that, don't have much going for me. Yeah, the early mint in mine, it was tempting, but it probably was not correct. Don't know what I should get instead, though. I had 5, right? Or 4 in the coffers. Maybe just a tragic hero. I already had the plaza. That's probably better. You can delay the mint like he did, and he got all 7 coppers with it. Seems better. And with the early mint, you spend like 2 or 3 turns doing nothing. Minting silver is also not something that you really want to do. I need more draw now, so maybe I can use my bandit, trash some golds with it. I would need a second bishop also, but all of that is just too slow, I think, because he has 24 money. Fool's gold is better than silver, is what I learned this game. Let's see what he gets. So he doesn't pathfind, probably because of the thing I said earlier. He has enough draw anyway. He doesn't want to pop the heroes. But he is kind of stretching it here. Should I discard? No. Yeah, shit. That was kind of risky, I think. Triple border village just wins for me, which I actually think I could have potentially done. So here, I just trash them in then by province, maybe. Or border village something. I think I need the province. Maybe province. No, fool's gold is pretty stupid. Just want to win next turn somehow and hope he can't outscore me. He can probably like triple. Yeah, let's do just province. Did I say province fool's gold? I don't have enough money for that. So, and also I have only 1 buy. And look at that, that's pretty nice. Can you somehow draw me a card? I think Border Village is my last card, right? Yeah, oh well. Yeah, I guess he can triple here. And then I just play the bandit and buy a plaza. I mean, with a better turn, I think I had it, maybe. Well, 18 is a lot, but I already had 14 last turn, and my deck got better because I did pathfinding, so yeah, I should have gotten there. I mean, with good draws.
This is nothing unexpected with the amounts of silvers I have, but I think he left something open there, which he shouldn't have given his position. Maybe he can. No, he can't win. That's a bit too much, isn't it? He would need three border villages. That comes with one duchy. And then still like double province duchy. That's. I think he doesn't have the money for that. Let's see. He does have 9 fool's gold, so I'm curious. 9 fool's gold is 25 alone, and then he has 9 coffers. Getting a call now. Why are people always calling me when I'm playing Dominion? Oh! Shoot. I missed an appointment. That's why. Oh, that's quite bad. So 6 spies. Does he have it? It's pretty cool. Nice. Dang it, wow, that's a lot of money. But I need to clarify this thing. Alright, I'm back. Another cool one. Looks like silver something. Silver. It's not so easy with the four. Maybe magpie? Sorry, yeah. So you want to trash estates mainly. There's draw. There's enough draw. Could see delaying the spice merchant for a bit. Let's try that. Yeah. Sure. Yeah, spice merchant is the obvious choice. Five, this is stables. And then here I get either spice merchant or temple. I mean, mainly I want to trash my estates, but spice merchant is still the better thing, right? Not at trashing estates though. Could take a border village here, that doesn't really inspire me. Well, now I'm taking it, but so if you have lots of actions in play, you can get some peddlers with traveling fare. Okay, guess I take another silver, which I could also not do, but I have the stables and I will be trashing my copper, so I think it's fine. No, I might get some peddlers. Maybe some peddlers in the city quarter. That's a bit far-fetched, but let's see what I draw here first. Do I put this copper into the shuffle to potentially do coins and buy with the spice merchant? I think not. Actually, maybe I do. So coins buy, that looks pretty good for the peddlers. Peddler still costs 2 effectively, but I can top deck all this. Oh, that's pretty great. I could also do peddler, border village, stable, city quarter, or I do more traveling fare, which is probably better. I'm still having this issue here of having to reschedule my thing that I just missed. Okay, so city quarter, draw a lot. Play the magpie. Put a silver into my hand, okay. I can do it again now, the thing. GG. Yeah, there was one good turn and then it was kind of over. So, the score now is 2-1. Mix Prosperity. Okay, whatever, let's just play this last game. which might not be the last game. Because I thought a moment that maybe I will have to call this and we might continue at another time, but should be okay. So this doesn't look like you can build a whole lot. You would have to empty cities. Looks like money to me. There's also quarry villa. So now I can fully concentrate on the game again. So I have 2-5. The question is, do you get the fool's gold, and what do you get with the 5? You could open fool's gold mine, which is funky. And then you get a crypt later. There's also silos, which is pretty neat. The fool's gold mine is intriguing. But fool's gold without draw is. But there's mine, and I will get a crypt. So that might actually be a thing. If I don't do that, I just don't get the fool's gold here and get like a treasure trove. Seems also decent. He's probably not contesting fool's gold, so I will probably get a whole lot of them. And also with the silos, it might be feasible. Treasure trove is also good with silos. Let's try it. I'm too curious to know how it will go. Yeah, and Quarry Villa I know, but what it doesn't score and so on. Here I get. Do I even get the. No, I get the silos, obviously. And here I discard 2. So he goes for the idols, which is also pretty good, probably. Discard all the coppers. So I could take a free villa here to have more buys, which I eventually need, so it's not something you usually do, but here I think it's fine. And then, well, I could take another one, but I'm not going to do that. So should I take an idol here? Having 2 idols, I mean, I'm not going to collide them all that often. I wonder if I should actually get cities now, because fool's golds will run. Could also get a crypt first. Crypt doesn't seem great. I said I'm not gonna build, so do I really get the city? Probably not. Let's get to crypt, which is not really great with no draw, but here I get my first curse. Don't really know what I'm doing, but it might still work. So yeah, that's kind of the fool, the crypt that you would expect. I hope I find my villa next turn, but I don't. Well, I could still discard this copper, which I probably shouldn't. So he also goes for the fool's gold. I think I'm just provincing here. The long game isn't really all that great for me because of his idols. So it's just green. It's not a curse. Take fool's golds, discard coppers, play city, 7, well this is city fool's gold, this is a bit unfortunate. I should have maybe, probably not, maybe milled a fool's gold. Yeah. The script was so bad. 2 cities. Well, let's just discard this copper. Which didn't really change anything. Should have maybe taken a baron or more villas at some point. Here I'm just taking the copper and discard it. Province. Hey, I can activate city if he doesn't do it. But he has more cities, right? Yeah, I think he has 4 and I have 3. He might be buying the fool's gold anyway. Yeah, I wonder what one should do here. No. I have to get the fool's gold here just to have some money. Even though it activates his cities as well. The duchy or city? Would be cool to get a city right before the shuffle. Few provinces. Well, he's in a good spot anyway. Probably has to be. I will have to get two of the remaining provinces. Everything looks quite bad here. So if I get duchy. 20. Let's get the city, even though don't like my chances in either of the lines, so. So if your province is now, I guess I just. Oh, wow, that's a good boon. I said I'm just going to province, but he doesn't even have to spend the coffers. Do I still go for it? Single duchy is also pretty much losing. Maybe I should have opened Treasure Trove. I don't know. I mean, it's just province, right? What's the disadvantage of province here? Am I doubling? No. I'd be happy if he gets like duchy. Doesn't make much sense to me. I mean, my deck is totally garbage. He can't expect me, wow, that, to double ever. But okay, now it's just province, which is fine. And suddenly it's anybody's game. Well, he's still ahead, but. Well, is he? Well, now he has to take province and hope that I don't get there, which is. Well, he can also take double duchy, I guess. Yeah, sorry. I have to take that back. Now I think he should double duchy. And I will just buy that beautiful estate. Well, I will discard copper, so maybe I find fool's gold, then I buy duchy. Okay, it's just single duchy, which is also fine. Nice crypt. Estate. Is copper worth it? Maybe. Well, it doesn't matter. I'm probably not shuffling again. Yeah, you can buy a duchy here. Do I dance? Yeah, I have to because he has five coffers. But my deck is it's like utter garbage. What was he got the draw boon somehow. You can also take province and then tie and then I win. That would be a good deal, I think. Yeah, he got Wind's Gift. That's why he bought the villa, because he drew city with it. I think it's an easy duchy. I have basically no chance of winning. Unless I just take the province. But he will have three. I mean, how can you not have three? Plus five coffers, I mean. I mean, you can't offer the tie here because I already have 2 points. What's it for game five, by the way? Am I starting player again or is it random? First things first. Yes. Yeah, so I can do nothing here. Can discard this. By Villa Duchy. Yeah, it was just a bad plan. I should also do the idle thing. I have 6 curses by now. 7. Just single duchy, gain of coffers. Yeah, I also somehow didn't get to patient. Maybe there was a time, but I didn't find it. Which is also probably a big mistake. I never really thought about it, just went on to buy these cities and stuff. This is just, yeah, as I said, single duchy. Gain of coffers. Could be province, estate, that's also fine. I'm not province duchying. Well, I think single duchy is safer. Yes. That's a pretty amazing turn for my standards. That she I guess that she this is more like the turns that I'm expected. Do I discard this copper or do I turn it into a silver? These are the very hard choices. Well, now just province duchy and I resign. Do it. Mix prosperity. Yeah, maybe either open idle or I think treasure trove without the fool's gold. That looks better. Can maybe somebody tell me who starts game five? That would be nice. Is it random or is it me again? I could also look it up somewhere. Pinned messages. Just keep alternating. Okay. Yeah, and I think if we tie, we just continue, right? Okay. I didn't look at the board yet. Let's see what we have. We have page and I have 2-5, which is good. What's going on otherwise? Lost arts, probably not needed if you got the teacher the champion fast enough. This is pretty explosive again. Well, I don't need to think about my two. I was gonna say I also don't need to think about my five, but I actually might have to. I'm not gonna do the min thing again. It would be cool if you hit five fast enough and then windfall and so on. Is it treasurer or counterfeit? Looks like treasurer to me. It's a pretty strong opening. Spice merchant or forager, probably spice merchant. Okay, so nothing misses, which is good. Here, where someone would like to get a forager if I can. Could also take the key and delay trashing a bit. I mean, there will be council room and enough draw, but trashing is still good. Fool's gold might also be a thing again here. Probably is. Gets a second page. I would have gotten the forager there. So here. I think I'm trashing and buying something. Seems like a good plan. Having counterfeit spice merchant and treasurer seems a bit much in terms of copper trashing. But what else should I get with five? Don't really see it, so. Well, I could have taken the key here. This should be fine. This trashes really quickly, and then I can get windfall. This is probably forage a page. Need to trash my estates too. It's a bit early for fool's gold, so let's do that. Yeah, taking these silvers is fine. It's not great. So do I need lost arts? No. I wonder if I needed lost arts before, because the champion will be so late, but here I think I'm just taking the key and buying a council room.
There's always a villa to help you out until you get to champion. Cards actions. Okay. So, should I start on the Fool's Gold already? Probably not. What about another page line? Taking silvers is... That's not really great. Second forager. Not a big fan of that either. Silver is ridiculous. Okay, let's get the Fool's Golds. Bit unfortunate that I don't find my forager with an estate and also discarded my council room. And he's at hero. And my warrior, what happened with my warrior? It's the last card, right? This is not going according to plan. Should I take the silver? So I have 6, 7, 8, 9. Could take the silver by double council room. Would be a bit unfortunate to play the council room and not have 4 for villa. That would be really unfortunate. So maybe, given that I am not even at hero yet, I think I'm doing this, which is really sad, I know, but I don't want to take like 5 villas just to support my council rooms and my other terminals. Yeah, and he is somehow far ahead. I don't know what happened there. Did I mess up, or did he just draw really, really well? I don't know. He's a champion, and I was even first player. I mean, what the heck? I will be drawing deck, treasuring an estate, get like, do I get the windfall, or is it not really efficient? Full scolds might just be better, but windfall is cost only 5, so, well, let's see, I do have this, lost archive, so... How many cards did he gain? Place a treasure hunter, gains 2 silvers. Gains a villa. Gains a counterfeit. Gains a council room. Gains 2 pages. I think that's 7. Wow. Okay, let's play this. So 7 cards, huh? Let's see if I can take that. So if I gain 7 silvers in my discard and then end my actions, or rather play like the treasure hunter to do whatever. I have 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10. Ten, 11, 13. I can get like council room, villa, for example. and then draw on. That should be fine. Maybe. Gain 7 silvers. Nice. So I have 4, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13. Can gain the silver back. Need more silvers. So counterfeit. Probably just the copper. Could be the silver. So I have 7 cards in the discard. If I counterfeit the silver, I have 15, 16, 17. Double council room, fool's gold villa. If I trash the copper, 13, 14, 16. Oh, I think I should keep the copper in hand for the spice merchant. Okay, so let's do it like that. Buy this. 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 And that. Let's see if I draw something other than silver. I don't. Oh, come on. Okay, so province fool's gold, maybe just double council room. Double council room looks decent. Could also be counterfeit council room, for example. It looks better. Not sure if it looks better actually. I wonder if I should even go up to a hero at this point. But probably I should. Yeah, I would have liked to see one more council room there. But having two in the starting hand is also fine. Trashing a warrior. But that looks like no more draw for him. I don't see why you would end your action phase otherwise now. Maybe I should have taken the last two, I don't know. I mean, only left one is what I mean. We need to green now. I think. So, do I gain counterfeit or fool's gold with that hero? What did I discard? What did I discard? So, fool's gold warrior and estate, so I can draw first here. Maybe. Gain. First of all, there might be a win here. Let's check for that. That's a bit hard to do. Okay, I have 7 silvers, that's 14, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 30, 30. Villa costs. How many buys can I get? I have 7 right now. 8, 9, 10, 11. Something like 13 buys. Okay, so it's not gonna end on fool's gold estates, I don't think, because of buys. F7, 8, 9, 13 buys. I think if I get a counterfeit here, 14, I can make that 14. Okay, and villa costs 3, so that's 21. I would need 21 plus 16 is 37. That's not what I have, right? F14 plus 4 is 18. Seven sellers is 14 plus 4 is 18. Copper 19. Counterfeit 20, 21, 24, 25, 26, 27. Gain a counterfeit 27, 29. Counterfeit fool's goals. I might have like 40 something. Yeah, but that should be enough then. Oh boy. So let's say I gain a counterfeit. I draw it. Is it better to gain a fool's gold? Don't think so. So then I trash an estate, which gives me 2 coins. Then I have 6. I play the treasurer. Then I have 9. I gain the silver. Then I have 11. 11. I have 7 silvers. So that's 25. I play 3 counterfeits. That's 28. I play 2 of these counterfeits twice. That's 30. I was at 28, right? So that's 30. And then I play a total of 4 fool's golds. That should be enough. So that's 31. And then I also play silver like twice. I think that should be it. And villa costs 3, it's 21. Plus 16, 37. I think it's enough. I think it's enough. Oh, wait, wait, wait a second. I can. I'm stupid. I can get, can get something in the shuffle. I can get something in the shuffle, like a fool's gold. But then I empty on fool's golds, right? But then I also need 2 estates with it. This is a bit annoying. Well, at least I can get a copper in the shuffle. That's better than nothing. Yeah, I think that's best. By copper villa. Yeah. Okay. By only 1 copper. There might actually also be other ways, like buying multiple spice merchants and keep on drawing and buying fool squads along the way, but that's too complicated. So let's do this, this, and then draw. I could also trash a fool's gold here to up my forager and then gain it back, but that's just not more money compared to just trashing the estate. And now gaining a silver. I play a total of 4 fool's golds, right? So the first one is 1 and the others are 4, so it's 13, 21. Yeah, that should be it. I should have maybe not done it in this order, but yeah, it's 40 actually. So I had quite some overshoot there, but I'm not good at counting, so. Cool. And now I can even get my champion. Isn't that nice? All right. So I, yeah. I win 3-2, which is good. I don't know who I'm playing next. I guess it's not even decided yet. That should be the quarterfinals then, maybe. I don't know. I'll have to look it up. But cool games as always. Thanks for watching. See you around. Bye bye.